Good afternoon. This is our population demographics lab. This is the PowerPoint that if we were on site, we would be in the computer lab and I would go through this PowerPoint step by step with you. With everyone at home, I'm still going to go through it and hopefully you can follow along at your own computer. On Blackboard, I have two sets of data. They are the length, weight, age, maturity, and sex of walleye from two different lakes. So you need to find both spreadsheets, one for lake one, one for lake two. We're gonna run all of these Excel statistics on those populations. The first one is catch at age. This is just making a histogram, but you're going to have to organize the data first so you know the ages when they were caught. Next up, we're making growth and length at age curve. So this diagram from our lab manual, you're going to reproduce this curve. So you're going to find the age and length of the different fish and plot a curve where it shows that the small fish are growing rapidly and then eventually it levels off. No matter how old the fish get, they seem to hit a max length, where they can grow older and older and older, and they're only getting microscopically longer and longer and longer. And we call that L infinity, the theoretical max length that a fish can get. So once you calculate that growth curve, then you're going to calculate what that L infinity length is. If in theory a fish lived hundreds of years, it's never really going to get much bigger than this length. A maturation curve is plotting for each age at each sex. So we're going to sort your data by sex, by age, by maturity, and find out how many males at zero were mature, how many males at one were mature, how many males at two were mature. And you're going to plot that into a graph. You're going to do this four times for each sex, as well as for each lake. So males and females in lake one, males and females in lake two. And you can see on this graph that the young fish aren't mature, and then there's a fast maturity, and then all the old fish are mature. So you sort of find out at what age is 50% maturity happening. Looking at survival and mortality rates, we're going to calculate how many fish we have in our population that are one, how many are two, how many are three, how many are four, how many are five. And you will use that data to figure out what the mortality rate is. It's tedious because you have to count all the fish, but it's not difficult. With this one, you'll combine the sexes, but you still have to do it for both populations. So after you've done everything, you're going to have two histograms where we did for lake one and lake two. Those are the how old they were when we caught them, so our age distribution. Then we're going to do four length at age graphs. So that's the L infinity graph, finding out where L infinity is. But we're going to do this for the two different sexes because the size of males is quite different than the size of females at the two different habitats. So lake one versus lake two, males and females of both. Same with our maturation rates. We're going to see how the males and females are maturing differently at those two populations. So it's four of those graphs. But then the mortality rates, we're going to combine the genders, the sexes, so it's just lake one and lake two. And then you might want to summarize all of that data into one table for whatever reason. You don't have to though, it's your report, small report or large report, just a thought. So if you're doing the short report, you only need to write results, a discussion, and then you need to have a literature cited where you're referencing your theories, your discussion points. Make sure your results section has a written results as well as some tables or figures depending on what you think is going to tell the best story. And you don't have to answer these questions, they're just some discussion points that I thought might help. If you're doing a full lab report, you're doing the whole everything. You're starting with a title and author, abstract, introduction, methods. And in your methods, you need to include what statistical analyses you did, a results, discussion, and just like with the short report, your results need to include written as well as tables and figures. They don't need to include all of them, just the ones that you need in order to tell the story that you're telling in your discussion. And again, you don't have to use these discussion points. They're just some ideas. And then you need a literature cited to cite the sources that you use to support the theories that you present in your discussion. Good luck, guys.